My name is Tatiana Netterfield. We're in Melissa Kemp's lab at Georgia Tech, and I am an undergraduate research assistant. There are many diseases associated with the dysfunction of peroxisomes, so such as diabetes. The work that I do could be potentially used in order to find translational applications for these diseases. I'm from St. Petersburg, Florida. I've always kind of been a nerd. When I was in high school, I had a really awesome biology teacher, and she just made biology really cool and like something really fun for me, so I kind of segued into that after taking that class. I came to Georgia Tech because I was interested in biomedical engineering, but I wasn't really sure about what I wanted to do, so I joined Dr. Melissa Kemp's lab my sophomore year. And after that first semester, I was kind of just hooked. There was no going back for me. I knew that a career in research is what I wanted to do. I'm interested in how things work fundamentally. I'm interested in how the cell functions that it does at the cellular level. And I want to be a part of, you know, finding these discoveries of what's really going on. I'm a very curious person. So this kind of work is kind of like heaven to me. So macrophages are these cells that basically their function in the body is to eat up these bacteria or any dead cells that are present within your body. And once they eat it, there are certain pathways within the cell that they use in order to break it down. So basically I'm looking at those pathways and seeing if there are other pathways with which, you know, that they're breaking down this stuff within your body. I do confocal microscopy in order to take videos of these two particles interacting with each other. And then after I take the videos, I basically look at them and quantify how these interactions are occurring. The red are the labeled peroxisomes within macrophages, and the green are the labeled phagosomes. So when they overlap, they kind of make a orangish color. So I basically see why they're overlapping and why they're interacting with each other. So these are two separate cells that I imaged the other day. The main methods that I use are transfection, where I incorporate plasmid DNA into the cells in order to label peroxisomes, and also fluorescently labeled LPS, which I feed my cells in order to see the phagosomes that I want to look at. And after all this, I put my cells under the confocal microscope and take these images over time to see what's going on. So in our lab, we have what's called a cell culture room. We're about to walk into the lab. So grab my lab coat. And so this is the cell culture room, where we have all the cancer cells and the cell lines that we work with. We have two biohazard cabinets in there. So we need to do all our work in these cabinets in order to make sure that there's no contamination occurring and that everything's kept in a completely sterile environment. So we spray everything we put in the hood with ethanol before putting it in, even the bottles. And then we also have a few benches where we do things like SDS page and immunoblotting. And we have things like a plate reader, all the toys that you really need in order to do this research. So in our lab, we're pretty close-knit. There's always a ton of people that are willing to lend a helping hand.
I recently saw Taken 3. That is a horrible movie.
Taken 3? The first one was good. Yeah.
Then after that, I just kind of...
I just don't get it. Like, how are they getting kidnapped so many times? We're all very friendly with each other, and it's a very cohesive, you know, kind of dynamic that we have. I have a grandmother who has cancer of the bladder, So I hope through my research one day that maybe I can find some way that the research that I do, how it can, you know, improve her quality of life and how, you know, it could potentially be related to that. You know, all those subjects that you'd have to take in order to have a career in research, they're pretty tough. But once you, you know, have a eureka moment of, you know, finally everything clicks, it's one of the most gratifying things ever. And this work that I do, I feel like is very gratifying. So, you know, my advice would be just to not give up and just to keep going, and it'll get better.